an anxious person, if you will, can be empathetic and supportive and be a cheerleader, I think.
Yes.
As opposed to being an enabler or not an, that's a bad word, I understand, but.
Well, it's semantics. Because when somebody starts moving into that chronic caregiving, taking care of another, what happens is that it starts to build up resentment. It starts to build up hurt feelings. I don't have needs in this relationship anymore that are independent from being a caregiver. It doesn't work.
Yeah.
So two people to be, you know, developing their own strength, whatever their issues are.
Right.
That's pro-relationship.
And I think that's true. So then that person, that resentment begins to build up, and it becomes a issue where, hey, look, if heaven forbid your partner develops some terrible disease, cancer or something horrible like that, nobody signed up for that, but that's almost different. It's out of the control.
Yes.
Asking your wife to understand why you won't go to the supermarket or can't pick up the kids from school.
Right.
Is a tall order. And so I always say that, you know, that your partner should become a cheerleader and a supporter, but you also have to acknowledge to them, like, I understand that you don't understand this. My fear is every bit as real as if you held a gun to my head, but I do understand there's no reason for it. And I'm going to work on that. So please just cheer me on while I work on that. Mm-hmm. You have to accept responsibility for the irrationality of the behaviors in a way. Mm-hmm. So, and I always say, you know, when you start to improve that, hopefully everything, the relationship begins to improve along with it, you would hope. Mm-hmm. But I don't know if you've, you know, been able to coach people through that. I would hope so.
Yes. Hope so.
Yeah. Good.
Yeah.
Very good.
And you know, anxiety is such a tricky thing, because anxiety to one person is empowering and energy, and anxiety to another is incapacitating.
Yes.
And it's not only just about, you know, levels of anxiety, but it's also about, you know, your history with anxiety and if it's done something to you that was negative.
Yeah.
Which is usually where the pairing happens, right?
Right.
I'm in the car one day. I've always been a little bit anxious, but then I have this panic attack, so I'm no longer going to drive.
Yeah. We talk about that all the time. Unfortunately, how our brains work. Yeah.
Right. And you pull all the way back because you never want to have that happen again.
Right.
The truth
right.
is, it only happened one time in your 20 years or whatever it was.
It's so terrible that's the way it works. It only takes one to develop the phobia.
It only takes one, and then it's like, I can't go in the car anymore. And it's like, no, you need to get back in the car.
Right, right.
Bit so by bit by bit. And you
it
need
takes
to drive farther and farther and farther.
Correct. Well, it takes the one panic attack, but then it takes 150 repetitions of getting back in the car to
right.
It's,
right.
It's cruel. It's cruel.
It is.
You know, but our
Absolutely.
Brains seem so plastic and so elastic, I mean, that, you know, mm-hmm. you can mm-hmm. undo those habits. Mm-hmm. So I think you've been going for about 20 minutes. I don't want to take a whole lot of your time. Do you have anything in particular that you wanted to add to this? Or, I mean, I know it's a big topic. There's really no good. We can't give people, they do this, 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 and this, and you'll be fine, unfortunately.
First and foremost, I always encourage the courageousness of getting help. Getting help and taking up your own cause. If you want your life to be better than this, then you're going to have to fight for your life to be better than this. And sometimes that means reaching out to a qualified professional. Sometimes it means listening to a podcast. But if you're not where you want to be, then the work isn't done. And you need to keep fighting for yourself to get to a level where you're getting your functioning back and your life is what you want it to be. Hope, hope, hope never stops. And but we have to seize the reins and do the work and do the effort. But we're the ones who end up reaping when we do.
Well,
so I would say, you know, stay in the battle, get in the battle, be courageous enough to keep fighting for yourself and doing whatever it takes to get the help that you need to get to a better place.
Excellent. That's super good advice. I'm going to ask you one more question down that road, then I'll let you go. When people do reach out for help from a qualified professional, which I really encourage all the time,
good.
There seems to be a